deal with the Terror Blade, just split push or try and lasso him or something like that, silence him so he can't Sunder with their AoE silences. But as long as the OD is poor.
Woo! That's a hasted Hogtie pullback right there onto FY Jr., and he's going to be going down. He just got his right now, and they're going to follow it up with some damage onto this Tier 1, so it's going pretty good for IGB. They're keeping them Vici in check. They're finding some picks at the start. It didn't seem like it was going so well, but three kills.
And you mentioned that IG Vitality were trying to play a little bit greedy with the Iron Talon, but it's actually like Vici that were super far behind by just rushing.
Rolling Boulder, top lane. They're looking to go for DDC. That's going to be Dogfight's committing the Magnetize. That's a solo kill for sure. And he gets it done. Nice rolling.
To make things happen around the map. The Slardar doesn't have that much farm right now. He doesn't have his Blink Dagger yet.
Lane, Sakata getting frounced on. Looks like FY setting up a nice little
drums and almost Blink Dagger.
Yeah, I mean, he could have it with a
crazy
successful big fight here. Could do work. FY spotted. There's a roll of Dogfights. Gets another setup play here. Blips pull him back into the kinetic field. Snipe will come on through. Sakata gets the last word in on that one.
On the OD and their supports, but he's just like consistently getting kill after kill and without too much in the way to stop.
And Chaos breaking out here. They need to go for in July. Flies up and over. Sack Storm is going to be dropped to zone them back. Now Dogfight sweeps in. Gets off the Magnetize. Very nice. Little Hope get the finish on the Terrorblade. He's going to get dropped. Yang looking to slither on in. If he goes down, he will be delayed on that Blink Dagger. And he gets Glimpse pulled all the way back between the two. Nice two-man crush. But here comes the Lance flying in. Yang has nowhere to go as the boulder flies on forward. He is no Indiana Jones. He will not make it away. Sakata with the double kill. Big.
I believe what is a Midas, so they're gonna be like very far behind in terms.
Oh man,
maybe a big four network.
Looks like Inchalai's found someone to hog tie up. Pulls back the mighty Terrorblade, and with a Static Storm, he is caught in the dark.
Like he's gonna dodge the gank,
or he can get back in away. Dogfight's close, but Earthspear can't disengage fast. It looks like they will make the jump for him with that stomp, with that kill. He'll be the one to tank the gank. Super, feeling ambitious, running with the kinetic field. Look at this, a turnaround fight, a buyback from Dogfights, and he's looking to roll back into action right now. There's the glimpse, the catch, the pullback. It's on Yang. They bump it back and forward. There's going to be the move in as the disruption comes out to help him. The Magnetize is going to get dropped with a Static Storm on top of it. Oh boy, here we go. IGB looking to round up Vici Gaming. But still handing in it. ZYF is going to get bumped up with the boulder smash. Shot down in the back. Sakata, executioner style. Takes him off the map. Oh, and they're not even going to let precious little DDC make it away. A bop of the bat from Dogfights. On the extra range, the ability to force staff.
Oh, he has BOTs, but are they going to be able to get there in time? Roach, way too low. Don't think. Maybe. Nah, Amp's too strong.
It's like when you're at that yellow light. Have you gone to Gaming are baking on that with a hopeful setup. They have Dogfights hating in the wing zone inside of IGB. As here they go with their approach. Something seems a bit fishy. Sakata can get jumped on. There it is. Stag Storm is going to be on top of it. The counterplay is going to be the lasso. Grab back a DDC is going to pull him right inside that storm. A bump back flame break will also get the kill. That's going to be the Aegis down. Moving from Yang. Gets the bop. Takes Dogfights out of this one. There's the second life of Ghost now. And he moves in. He's looking to haunt his way through. And he will get the grab on the Super. Yang gets the crush off as Paparazzi makes his own.
It's a team fight because you don't know where they are. It's better to throw out a scan.
Dogfights hanging down by that bomb tower as it goes down and it's going to get jumped on. But here comes the reinforcements from IGB and it's going to allow them to get a nice bump back takedown of Yang. And a desperate Sunder helps to keep End alive. Flash forward a second as we're going to have a bit of lag as they bump back it away here. But still only the one for one trade. Vici Gaming came in here to get that tower.
Bottom lane rolling on in.
July could be in trouble here. End is in pursuit, and with that blink, Ghost is going to be able to get off the Astral Imprisonment. And oh my god, begins to just hit him hard. The crush will be there from Yang, too.
The net worth with the way that he's playing. He's not, asserting his dominance. Just like showing them who's boss. Just like constantly harassing people with the illusions, like popping smokes and being elusive.
Injuli does that, but Injuli almost does it too much, where he's way ahead of his team. But they will get the Eclipse pullback here for Yang into the Dogfights Magnetize. But here comes the OD. Sanity's Eclipse does some good damage, but not going to be able to get the finish. Injuli still holds on strong in those back lines. And now Dogfights, Boulder Smash on forward. PL suddenly does not like his trade against the Terrorblade and opts to pull on back. Hits up Ghost a bit. Oh, Ghost taking a lot of damage. And he's going to be forced to self-astral to just make it away from the trouble. Dogfights will be left behind, and he'll be going down. And that's going to be the cue for IG to just get the hell out of there. if they can. Super needs 9 seconds before he's going to have a glimpse, and 5 seconds before there's going to be a kinetic field. How are they going to be able to stop him? Injolai opts to pull out the lasso now. Looking to go for hopefully a takedown onto Yang and the sniper. Oh, Astral just in time.
He tried to force out the PL so that he could survive. He was really close to it.
Injolai's had enough, and he's looking to kind of get something back the way of IG, and they will be able to get the snipe and take down a static storm just to ensure the safety of the sniper, but he's still not safe. The chase is still on. Drops a shrapnel, is able to cancel their blinks. Thank God. He's running. He's even trying to stop and hope that slows him. Okay, all right. Nice boulder smash. Nice grip comes in, but it wasn't going to save him yet. What the biggest sniper bait known to man, pulling in not one, but two. They're going to get ghost as well. What the hell was that? A fugitive on the run, and they're just taking all the police.
Doppelganger,
and yeah, walks back and away. He has no life.
They could, alternatively, the supports could have had an urn, but this was a really good opportunity for them.
Well, we do have an urn on the Earth Spirit. He's just holding the charge, it looks like, for now. But now Paparazzi in a bit of trouble, going to be forced to doppel. Oh, had to pop the BKB because he saw Yang go for the crush, but Yang canceled it.
Okay, that
and
BKB
owned. And now back onto him, and they're going to get it done. Okay. He will still get shot down from behind, though. That was a sniper illusion about
Nightmare when you have to build a MKB on OD. Bloodthorn like kind of solves it, but you can just mant that off now.
Ooh. They managed to get a hold of the DDC here. He insta-dies. And Injolai looks for more. Managed to get the grab on the Terrorblade. Pulls him back. They're waiting for the Sunder. It's going to be going off. It's on Sakata. He runs back and away. He's going to be able to get the Force. Puts himself in a good position. Now begins to pop off the shots. Looking to go in. Paparazzi's in a lot of trouble. Doppelganger will put him back in away. Stagstorm's going to be committed. They all look to bounce back. And it's going to get shot down in the face. Sakata gets that one now dominating. And with this win, could get him a good Roche secure. Yang's responsibility to help start it. Like, just isolating, finding out what the sniper is, and hoping that your team's going to be able to go for it next. For now, it only spots out Injolai, so they'll quickly take out the Batrider.
That's a second gem.
All right. Good smoke, good move in.
And they have not protected Roche. Wow. Jeez.
Well, PL just opts instead to go up to the top and go for the tier 2, and BG will rightfully take this Roche for theirs. And that'll be the third straight Roche, all from BG.
Oh,
and
man.
It's going to go to OD again.
OD's also itemized for armor, which gives a little bit more merit to Maelstrom. I don't know, it's a tough choice. I don't actually know what the best choice for here is.
Spotted out Dogfights, and nice Astral before he can even boulder out. He'll be taken care of. It's that awkward spot in the late game when, unless you have a lance that allows the lasso and then the Force pullback into a nice boulder smash, there's the Silence Follow-up and a Static Storm. And they will get the Aegis down. It's a lot committed for it. Can they take the second life? Looks like BG and the rest of them on the way. He'll stall things out with the actual Prismat. Then he'll hop to the low ground. His end begins to go to work. Popping his BKB and popping out the Metamorphosis. And the Manta begins to shoot everyone down, including the PL. Without a chance, he just gets absolutely blasted. And it is going to be BG Gaming, rightfully, moving on forward. So much invested from IGV. They get the grab on Ghost, but they only able to take down the Aegis. Nice little slide there from Sakata. Will avoid the crush. Will he bait another one in? Looks like he may. Oh, before they can even move in and try to get the Glyphs pull back, it is all Ghost jumping in and shooting down the two. It's going to be forcing out buybacks already from IGV. This could be the beginning of the end as they get another triple kill for the OD. Can IG even hold? They're already making the move in. It looks like they've been able to spot out the sniper here. They're going to catch with the Astral Prismat. He pops the Manta, scoots away, gets a double force, which helps avoid the crush of Yang. But unfortunately, that means that the Disruptor's going to have to take that shot. Injolai picks it up, gets the lasso, gets the pullback. But there was a nice Astral to help him a bit. Yang's going to pop his BKB, and he will sprint out from the PLS 4K saved up. I know a chunk of it's going to be saved for some buyback, but he does not have the buyback timing yet. And they're making their move onto him. He's going to be forced to BKB, and, well, I don't think he has the health to survive. They just beat the snot out of him.
He will
be taken out. Hoping to get a grab on the Yang through the Static Storm, but that's a disruption, and now that Static Storm is going to be doing a whole lot. Very ballsy, deep committed dive. ZYF feeling like an unstoppable force will just quickly shred apart the Disruptor and then get back to work on doing justice in the base. IGV, I imagine the towel to be thrown in as PL will not even be there to defend. Hammer dropped inside the fountain will be a quick and easy takedown, and that will be the game. Score of the kills is 23-27, Ben, but it didn't feel like that. BG Gaming, certainly by the back half of this one, had absolute control of the game. That third Aegis was certainly, as they say, the nail in the coffin.
I forget which team they remind me of in that they have like a really good first 15 minutes and then their team fight and decision making from there is just terrible. And it's a sign of a team that doesn't have a lot of experience. You don't have those like super